tempo della primavera.
Hi, here comes the second part of the story of Sash.
La primavera dell'amore.
So many people said, Sash, you know, is German, success in England, having a French song, a Spanish song, an English song. So which language are you doing next? So we decided to do an Italian song. So that's how the idea of La Primavera was born. So a mixture between Ecuador and State. It went to number 3.
Senti.
I was nominated at the Brit Awards '98, exactly. Best International Male, and it was, I think, John Bon Jovi, it was Sash, and it was someone else, I can't remember the third one. But at the end, John Bon Jovi got it. It was, again, a special day in my life. Tina Cousins was already there before I met, and she made a couple of songs before. I remember I was playing, I think it was in Manchester, and I was just standing on the side like, she looks hot. And she could sing even very, very good. And I said, wow, this would be a perfect girl to sing a Sash song. For me, it was amazing again that this number made number 2 in the UK chart. Don't be afraid to get lost this time. Move Mania came actually around end of September, October. And yeah, we sent a mail to America and asked the management of Shannon and said, hey, we have a song here. Are you able to do it? And they were really, really happy. Of course, for her, it was as well a kind of chance to break into the dance market and the music market again. I worked with Kylie Minogue together. I met Kylie on a concert in Cologne, and it was already so 99% clear that Kylie is singing as well as Sash song. And we produced already one song for her, and it was called Gimme Tonight. And this is a song what still is spreading in the internet, because actually at the end it was never released. I mean, Color of the World, I must say, is still one of my favorite Sash songs. And I always, you know, focus on really outstanding voices. And for me, the Dr. Alban raps are very outstanding from its voice. We have been on Iceland with like minus 40 degrees shooting the video 3 days, and amazing place. I mean, that's one of my favorite places in this world. I mean, Iceland is just wow.